So we talked about wine tanks, pole barns, horse barns, and I think you were going to talk a little bit about a marine
application.
Yeah, Long Beach is the biggest port in the United States, and we've done several boat hulls at the bottom of the boat. And we use marine foam that can handle oil, salt water, fiberglass boats. It helps for flotation. If there's any cracks or holes in the boat, it can keep it afloat. A lot of freshwater racing boats use it to where if there is a wreck, if they come apart while they're racing, the boat stays afloat instead of sinking them to the bottom. They use it as a safety precaution to keep the boat afloat. If there is any issues taken in water, the boat will still stay afloat.
So is it something that would be applied during manufacturing, or can it be retrofitted?
Both. There's constant problems of boat hulls leaking. Remember, it has a moisture barrier in there. So we can go in there and older boats do spray foam. It actually toughens. Remember, it builds structural integrity. So it can do that to a hull, a boat hull as well. It makes it a lot more sturdier. You spray it in between the stringers of the boat, just like you would the framing of a house. It would help keep the boat watertight, add a flotation device to it. On boats, a lot of times, oil from the engine ends up in the bottom of the hull. Anything that drips down from the boat ends up into the hull, and usually the bilge picks it up and pumps it out. So it would catch it in the bilge, and it wouldn't soak into the insulation because it's water resistant.
I imagine it must be a challenge to actually apply because you're going to be in extremely kind of restricted spaces.
Well, there's plenty of boatyards that you go to their boatyard. Doing it out on the water, that's when it can be an issue.
Getting to the inside of the hull.
It's a tight fit.
Do you have a really short guy that you...
Oh, a really short guy? No.
Or do you just do you just make a policy of employing small children?
Well, and there's awfully big boats, too, out here. You know, I'm talking military ships as well.
Oh, right.
Yeah, there's more than just little pleasure boats.
So it doesn't...
You can get in some monstrous boats. We're talking cruise liners, military ships, fishing boats, 60, 70-foot long fishing boats. Yeah.
Are there any restrictions in terms of the type of boat? Or it apply, basically, what you're saying is it applies to virtually any type of boat, whether it's a large commercial liner, a military ship of some kind, or a cargo carrier, or a sailing yacht. It would apply equally to all boats of all sizes?
Yep.
That's an application for spray foam I would never have thought of.
Some boats have been engineered without it, but some have it engineered with it, and some older boats that might have a problem to where they need more structural integrity or they need more waterproofing or just want a better ride out there on the water can use spray foam.
Huh.